My beloved sisters and daughters, another very important quality that we need to instill in ourselves, the quality of patience, forbearance, what is known as sabr. Sabr is something you need no matter what you are doing in your life. You are married, you need sabr. You are not married, you need sabr. You are teaching, you need sabr. You are not teaching, you need sabr. You are employed, you need sabr. You are not employed, you need sabr. Everything, you need sabr. What is the meaning of sabr? You restrain yourself from that which is haram. You endure when it comes to that which is obligatory upon you. And at the same time, you will have to bear patience, or you will have to surrender to the decree of Allah when something you do not like has happened. But it's Allah's choice. So, you know, I'm sure a lot of you have had family members who've passed away. What could you do? You could say, "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un." We belong to Allah, and to Him is our ultimate return. And we can perhaps read a dua or say something, "Inna lillahi ma akhadha wa lahu ma a'ta wa kullu shay'in 'indahu bi ajalin musamma." That, you know, for Allah belongs that which He has taken, that which He gave in the first place. And everything according to Allah comes with a specific time. It comes with an expiry date. I have an expiry date, and so does everything else, including the battery in this torch right now. Subhanallah. But when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His decree is final. I cannot have a say in the date of my death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us forgiveness the day He takes us away. So bear patience. Be forbearant. Do not want to break a marriage just because of one problem you have. Two problems you have. Five problems you have. So what? Others are suffering 50 problems. They are still working on their marriages. Remember this. Your marriage will not be rosy. Why? It's a test from Allah. Marriage is not just a honeymoon. I need to go and start saying, "Right, that's my man, and this is what it is, and I'm walking around in town. Everyone must see me, smell me, look at me, and my hair needs to be different every other day." That's not Muslimin. Wallahi, it's a fact. People are wasting $35 a week on their hair, yet they cannot even afford to buy food for their own families. This is what's going on in this country, wallahi. People are ready to buy nails to add on top of these nails of theirs. But when it comes to the evening, they will say, "There is no food in this house." This is what is happening. Wallahi, it's a fact. And this is the issue. We are people who are content. Consider it a test from Allah. Things will flash on the side. Things will flash on the side. Never ever turn to what is flashing. Lead your real life. That's all fake. Let me tell you. Sometimes people ask, "Well, why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts on the sides of what I have so many different temptations?" And He says, "This is a temptation, that's a temptation, stay away from it." Well, if He wanted me to stay away from it, why did He put it there in the first place? That's what some people ask. Well, I can tell you, when you know the answer in mathematics, still they give you multiple choice. You know what is multiple choice? They glare the wrong answers in your face in order to test you. You know the right answer, put a tick on the right answer. For example, if I were to tell you 10 multiplied by 10, A, 1, B, 10, C, 100, D, 1000, what would you say? Subhanallah. These are wrong answers. You can't say, if you wanted me to answer it right, why did you give me three other wrong options? You can't say that, because I'm testing you. I know you know what is right, so now I'm showing you everything that is wrong. You are supposed to be a believer, powerful enough to be able to say, "I'm putting my tick on the right answer. Here it is. It is answer number C, tick." There you are. Now you have won. So don't say, "Oh, what about all these other people?" Forget about them. They are ticking D, they are ticking A, they are ticking B. At the end of the day, when they collect all those papers and the kitab comes, Allah says, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَهُ. Those who are given their results in the right hand, the book in the right hand, they will be so happy, so proud, they will say, "Oh, here, read my book. See my results. Look at it. Beautiful." And those who are given in the wrong hand, the left hand, they will say, "We wish we were not even here today. We wish we were dead." Those are the ones who are ticking on the wrong answers. But it is our duty to try and reach out to them, to correct them, to remind them, to tell them, to tap them, to say, "You know, my sister, this is what Islam is all about." Do not spread Islam in an embarrassing way, or in a way that is not befitting a Muslim, spreading the goodness of the deen. We want to spread Islam, but in a good way. Live as a Muslim. They will see your happiness. They will see your contentment, your concentration on matters that are supposed to be within your concentration. So concentrate on these things. Be patient. Everything you do in life, one day it will go wrong, besides your link with Allah. Every day you do in life, one day it has to go wrong. Allah will test you. You know, you come to work every day at 8 o'clock, okay, for example. There will come a time when something happened to the combi, something happened to the transport, something happened here, you were late. And how people deal with it is all your tests. You were not late because you wanted to be late, because Allah is now testing you. Hey, today you will be late, nothing of your choice. When you go to work, they will shout you, they will scold you, they might cut your salary. Let's see what you do. It's part of your test. That's life. That's the challenge. So when you come, if you start swearing, shouting, hating, you have lost the test. You ticked on the B instead of the right answer. Now, if you come back, you apologize, you say, look, I'm very sorry. They say, we're going to cut your salary. Try to explain to them in a nice way and try to say something in a good way. Still, they don't agree. Say, okay, no problem. What can I do? You know, inshallah, next time it won't happen. Then you ask Allah, oh Allah, guide these people. They are cutting my salary. Nothing of me. But you did not cause a commotion. One day they will realize and understand, this person here, you know what? They are honest. One day after 10 years, 15 years, you may get a promotion. Something may happen. You might not get it. But when you go down into your grave, Allah knows what happened. That is your Jannah. Allah knows what happened. So it was never between us and them. It is between us and Allah all the time. Remember this. These are the qualities of dua. These are the people who will enter Jannah with ease. And I haven't even spoken of many more qualities. But this quality of sabr is something very, very interesting.